Let the October light settle in this place and wash our table in the watercolors of autumn, the deep yellows and burnished orange, the gifts of God in creation. In this harvest light, we place our bread newly baked and pour wine long fermented in celebration of the gifts of God. For we are drawn to these, the grain of the land and the grape of the vine, for in such simple things that even the poorest can own, wrapped in crust and held in every shimmer, we find the whole story, the sacrifice of heaven. This pauper's feast, celebrated today in the stained glass glory of cathedrals and in this simple space and at home. So your love and your grace and your beauty is made known as our table overflows with the greatest giving. So let us gather here in autumn's light and share this feast sown in the earth and now harvested for our world, the gift of peace, the gift of justice, the gift of love. Amen. Well, you're very welcome to this service. You have braved it out in the wilds of the Glasgow weather, to which we welcome the world to Glasgow. Welcome, world. This is what we have to live with here in Glasgow. May they be blessed. And maybe you be blessed for being here. You're in the right place for this next hour of worship. We have a joint service today. We have friends from Rockhill Calvinside joining friends from Maryhill Parish Church and also friends from the Praying Hands Asian Church that are joining us too for this special service of communion. You'll see that the table is laid and all are welcome at this table. There are people also joining us from home. They're in the Zoom room and hopefully they will help us with our Bible reading in the service, and all the words will appear through the wonders of the modern technology. And it's really, really special that we can join in this way and include even those who join at home. If you're at home, you know it's communion and you know that you would need to get something to eat and something to drink when that moment arrives towards the end of the service. Otherwise, for those of you who are in the building, and maybe you were with us last month when we celebrated communion at Rockhill, we'll be doing it in the same way. I'll be inviting you forward. I'll be inviting you row by row, first row, second row, third row, and you'll come and you'll stand and you'll take the bread and you'll move across and you'll take the wine and then you'll head back to your seats. And hopefully in an orderly fashion, we'll be able to stay safe and receive the elements of communion. The theme is all about communion. There's a lot to fit in to today, and so the sermon will be about what that sacrament means to us. But there's also people joining us and becoming new members today, and they will stand in their places and make their promises, and they'll be joining Maryhill Parish Church, or indeed Rockhill Calvinside Parish Church, and they know who they are. And I'm just looking to see if anyone's in the Zoom room who might be joining us today, but no, that's not the case. At least at this stage. But there's a couple of names that I'll read out who can't be with us today, but they will be joining us all the same in membership. The last thing to say is just the announcements in terms of what's coming up. Next Sunday is also a joint service for Maryhill and Rockhill. I'm joining together, but this time at Rockhill Calvinside Parish Church on the 7th of November. There will be no service here. On the 14th, there will be Remembrance Sunday. It will also be a joint service, but this time we will be here in Maryhill and there will be no service at Rockhill. So please try and be patient with us as we continue to alternate in this moment. The Kirk Session meet on the 9th of November and there'll be further plans made as to where we meet heading up towards Christmas. And that's all I can tell you about that just now. Also this week, you'll know that the city has a big event on, and there's all sorts of opportunities for you to get involved in this. In our WhatsApp group in Maryhill Parish Church, we'll light a candle at 7 o'clock each night And different people, I hope, will lead us in a wee thought and a prayer at 7 o'clock as we think about all that's happening and as we think about how we can care for the world that God has given us and use our voices strongly for change. There's also opportunities to join in local events. There's the Day of Action that we're encouraging you to get involved in on the Saturday, which is a march from Kelvin Grove to Glasgow Green. And we're encouraging you, if you want to join with us, meeting at the Kibble Palace at 11:15 to then walk to Kelvin Grove, because otherwise we'll all get lost. So you're welcome to join us in stages at any point along the way. But if you want to be with us for the whole journey, come at 11:15 to the Kibble Palace on Saturday. Beyond that, there's many other things, including the chance to be involved in an art installation. We had a lovely service last Sunday with our friends from the Immaculate Conception across the road, and it was to start off our thinking about COP. And there are leaves that Rebecca and Hannah have created that we will be writing a pledge on, a pledge, a small change, a difference that we might want to make in our own response to what is happening. And so Rebecca is really encouraging you, and I am too, to head through to the small hall at the end where tea and coffee will be served, and to put your pen mark on a leaf and to make a pledge. And then this will all be made into something beautiful that will be cited both here and across the road. And so it's a pledge for COP. Have I said all I needed to say, Rebecca, about that? Great. She'll look after you at the end of the service. Head on through and do that. Let's pause there as we come to think about where we are and why we're here and how God is good to us. And we come and gather to sing an opening hymn. It's called Let Us Build a House. So we're just going to sing verses 1, 3, and 5.
Thank you.
We come to our opening prayers, and towards the end of this, we share the Lord's Prayer together. Let's pray. Loving Lord, we thank you that you have called us together as your people, your church, your family united in Christ. We thank you for your love and acceptance that allows us to stand in your presence, that allows us to belong, to feel love and give love as we meet together in your name. We thank you that Jesus has called us to be his friends, that as we gather and eat together, he is with us, beside us, in us. And as we share with him, we share with you, tasting life in all its fullness. On this special Sunday, around this special meal, Lord, we ask that you would be with us. Share with us that we might grow in faith and in love, and your love overflow into our lives, to those around us, and to those who we have yet to meet. To care for the lost and the broken, the feeble and the frail, the foolish and the fragile. Equip us for service in your world. For we, in your name we ask it, and in your words we pray together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We now come to our Bible reading, and it's not from the Gospels, and it's not from the Old Testament. It's a letter to the people of Colossae. So it's from Colossians.
Thank you. Yes, I'm going to lead us in our reading today. So as Stuart says, it's from Colossians 1, verses 1 to 14. From Paul, who by God's will is an apostle of Christ Jesus, and from our brother Timothy, to God's people in Colossae, who are our faithful friends in union with Christ. May God our Father give you grace and peace. We always give thanks to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you, for we have heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of your love for all God's people. When the true message, the good news, first came to you, you heard about the hope it offers. So your faith and your love are based on what you hope for, which is kept safe for you in heaven. The gospel keeps bringing blessings and is spreading throughout the world, just as it has among you ever since the day you first heard about the grace of God and came to know it as it really is. You learned of God's grace from Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is Christ's faithful worker on our behalf. He has told us of the love that the Spirit has given you. For this reason, we have always prayed for you, ever since we heard about you. We ask God to fill you with the knowledge of his will, with all the wisdom and understanding that his Spirit gives. Then you will be able to live as the Lord wants and will always do what pleases him. Your lives will produce all kinds of good deeds and you will grow in your knowledge of God. May you be made strong with all the strength which comes from his glorious power, so that you may be able to endure everything with patience. And with joy, give thanks to the Father, who has made you fit to have your share of what God has reserved for his people in the kingdom of light. He rescued us from the power of darkness and brought us safe into the kingdom of his dear Son, by whom we are set free. That is, our sins are forgiven. Amen. And I pass back to Stuart.
A wonderful reading. Thank you for it, Iona. I've realized that there was an announcement I missed, and I'll get into so much trouble from Jean McKenzie if I don't read it. It's the Guild that meets tomorrow at 2 p.m. sharp, and it's Robert Watson, our very own Robert Watson, who is speaking. So please join the Guild if you can tomorrow, or ask Jean or Robert about it. Robert's going to speak about Edinburgh, our capital city. Very good, Robert. I'm looking forward to it. I'll be there. We're going to sing once again, and how lovely it is to sing in company and with people of good voice. We're going to sing How Deep the Father's Love for Us. It's become a modern classic for us, and one that we very often would sing on a communion Sunday. And again, if you're in the room and wish to stand to sing, please do. How Deep the Father's Love for Us. So as I was thinking about what to say today, I looked to the hills for inspiration and I saw only grey. It's been a pretty tough week and I'm struck by how much the weather and the onset of winter affects my mood. I think that this time of year is not easy for many. We can easily find ourselves retreating into our shells. Just how will we get through this winter? We reach for strength and courage beyond ourselves. Well, today, We've chosen to be here. And I'm grateful for that. A service of communion, a joyful feast where we consume a morsel of bread and a little cup of juice. It's ordinary bread and juice, but we call it Holy Communion, the Lord's Supper. And here we give thanks for the strength and courage that come through the gifts at this table. We take communion because Jesus started this meal when he ate with his disciples. Sometimes when we share this feast, it means something significant to us. But at other times, it might seem like we're going through the motions. It might seem mechanical. So what should happen to us at communion? Well, I'd like to think that we're all changed. We're all transformed by this meal. But I'm sure there are also times when we have the experience but miss the meaning. Sometimes we're too preoccupied, too distracted, or depressed. But we come here anyway because we know it's the right and proper thing to do. I wonder, how do we come here today? Well, this meal, of course, is connected with all of our meals, where we take a moment to stop and thank God for the food. But at this table, something more is happening than taking a sip of juice and a morsel of bread. What happens here is more than bread and wine. We believe that God is feeding us spiritual food here, food for the soul. If we are receptive at this table, our spiritual life is strengthened. But we still have to go home after church. We still have to cope with all that life throws at us, the wind and the rain and the dark nights of winter. We still have to deal with our basic human nature. Some of us are grumpy. Some of us are short-tempered. Some of us are surprisingly cheerful. Some of us struggle with our mistakes and our failures. But God still eats with us. He still invites us around the table to share in the ordinary bread and juice. And here we find that our grumpiness does not have the final word. Our mistakes and failures do not have the final word. Here we have the chance to taste and see that the Lord is good. In this meal, we have the chance to really receive the good news, to take into our very bodies the gifts Jesus has given us. The forgiveness, the nurture, the courage, the compassion. In a sense, we are taking Jesus' life into our lives. He is with us and within us. We may not feel different after one meal, one Lord's Supper, but over time, this feast deepens for us, and we are given the spiritual sustenance we need. What happens here? Well, it's a feast on many levels. It may not have occurred to us that this is the only ritual of the church where all of our senses are involved. We see the bread, we touch it and taste it. We smell the juice and we hear the words, Christ's body is broken for you. What should happen at this meal? Well, we are fed by God's grace. We are strengthened to be the body of Christ in the world. In other words, the entire Christian faith, the gospel, is summed up in this meal. And I say all this about communion because I hear these meanings offered through the lines of Paul's letter to the Colossians that Iona started us off on today. It says, if you've been redeemed by Christ, then it's time to put on the new self, the true self, the Christ self. We are to put on this new self the way we put on our clothes. It says, Christ is your life. In a real sense, at the Lord's table, we find the fullness of life that God intends for all of us. This meal then is a chance for us to take it all in, to digest the spiritual food of love and mercy and compassion. As Jesus said, I have come that you may have life and have it to the full. Sometimes we settle for too little. We settle for our lesser life. We settle for our lesser nature. We settle not for abundant life, but for mediocre life, for half-awake life. But God wants to give us so much more. God wants to have us with the fullness of life. This is what should happen at communion. We receive the fullness of life, and may it be so today. If we take communion as an ordinary meal, we feed our stomachs and not our spirits. If we take communion as an ordinary meal, we miss the deeper nurture for our souls. If we take communion as an ordinary meal, we miss the fullness of life that God wants to give us. If we take communion as an ordinary meal, we miss the call to rise from our dull days, to see a new vision, to be the creatures, the people we are meant to be. For this is God's word for us today. Amen. So now, as we prepare to gather around this table, we will hear a song again that's become special to us in the last year and a half, as we've gathered in the Zoom room often, and at all times and places to share in communion. And it's a song called Holy Communion. And I'm going to pass to Iona, and she's going to play that for us.
Gracious Father, we give you praise and thanks for this holy communion, the body and blood of your beloved Son. The body is broken, God's love poured open to make us new. Lord, make us new. Abba, Father, we bless your name and take part in this holy communion. Make us all one, to love like your Son. The body is broken, God's love poured open to make us new. Lord, make us new.
The table is now ready. It is the table of company with Jesus and with all those who love him. It is Christ who invites us to meet him here. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Dear God, what a privilege it is to share in this special meal together, to meet in our homes and in this building and to know your love. For in this sacrament, Christ comes close to us, and we come close to Christ. Lord, be with us in a special way, and breathe your Spirit upon us and upon this bread and wine. May they become for us your body, vibrant with your life, healing, renewing, and making us whole. And as the bread and wine which we now eat and drink are changed into us, may we be changed again into you, bone of your bone, flesh of your flesh, loving and caring in the world. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Jesus, who walks on the road of our world's suffering and is made known to us in the breaking of bread on the night of his arrest, took bread. And having blessed it, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you. In the same way, he took wine, and having given thanks for it, he poured it out and gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new relationship with God, sealed with my blood. Take it and share it. I shall drink wine with you next in the coming kingdom of God." Let's pray together. Loving God, it is through your goodness that we have this bread and wine to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. What we do here is celebrate the life that Jesus has shared among his community through the centuries and shares among us now. Made one in Christ and one with each other, let us offer these gifts and with them ourselves, a single holy living sacrifice. Amen. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this wine, you show the Lord's death until he comes again. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. So I invite you now, in your own time, and as you feel ready, to come to the table. I invite the front row to take the lead. The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. We're going to sing one more hymn. We're going to split it into two parts. We're going to be welcoming new members shortly, and this is very much with them in mind. I remember singing this song about 15 years ago and it being very special to me, and so I admit it's a sentimental pick this morning. It's called Take This Moment, Sign and Space, and I sang it at Renfield St. Stephen's as I was standing alongside my fellow probationers training in ministry, and with my good friend Graham and with Julie beside me, we were able to say a few words of thanks to those who had been with us on the journey. And I remember being able to say about the various sort of bishops that had served me and been with me and had given me the experience that I'd needed to get to that stage 15 years ago. And I remember reserving some thanks and getting quite emotional, thanking my dad for all that he'd done for me in ministry at that point, and he continues to do that for me. So this is a sentimental pick. It's called Take This Moment, Sign the Space, and I hope it is meaningful for those who are coming forward as new members today in their journey in the church. So I invite you once again to stand and sing. If you know this one, we're going to sing the first four verses of Take This Moment, Sign and Space. Thank you. I know it's not one that's familiar to many of you, and we've still got one more verse to keep and to sing at the end of this time. We are delighted to say that today we are welcoming some new members into our church family here in this part of Glasgow. So can I ask those who are becoming members today to stand in your places? Fabulous. We have Wendy and we have Jill and we have Alan and we have Sheila and we have Heather and Karen and David. And it's wonderful to have you here becoming members. In this act, we remember our baptism and how over the years we have come to know the reality of God's love in our lives and the Holy Spirit within us. And so those standing today come to confess their faith, to promise to walk with Jesus and to run the race of life with us here in this church. And we are delighted that you feel ready to take this step of faith as we welcome you warmly into the church family. Jesus said, If you tell others that you belong to me, I will tell my Father in heaven that you are my followers. In Galatians, it says, God's Spirit makes us loving, happy, peaceful, patient, kind, good, faithful, gentle, and self-controlled. God's Spirit has given us life, so we should follow the Spirit. And in Romans, it says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. All you who gather here today, I invite you to confess your faith too. So that's why I've given you an order of service today. It's the first one I've printed in a year and a half, I think. And so pass them around to make sure that we have the words on the reverse side, because it's an opportunity for us all to say the creeds of the church together and to say what it is that we believe. So make sure you've got a sight of these if you can, because they're spread around the room. Has everybody got something to say? So I ask you all to confess together with those standing the faith of the church to which we belong. Do you believe and trust in God the Father? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now I address only those standing, and I have three promises for you to make, and your response is I do, which we all do together. Do you promise to be faithful in reading the Bible and in prayer? Do you promise, depending on the grace of God, to profess publicly your loyalty to Jesus Christ, to serve him in your daily work, and to walk in his ways all the days of your life? Do you promise, as far as you're able, to join regularly with your fellow Christians for worship, prayer, and to hear God's word? So be strong and immovable. Always work enthusiastically for the Lord, for you know that nothing you do for the Lord is ever useless. Defend, O Lord, your servants gathered here this morning with your heavenly grace, that they may continue in your love forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit until at the last they come to your everlasting kingdom. For we ask this in your precious name. Amen. Amen. Before we sing our final hymn, can I invite you to offer a welcome and greet our new members? We cannot give shakes of hands or hugs, but there are other ways to show our affirmation and our welcome. I invite you to give them a round of applause. Thank you. Thank you so much. Be seated. And we now sing the final verse of the song that we were singing, Take My Talents, just one verse. Thank you, Meg. Take my talents, take my skills, take what's yet to be. Let my life be yours, and yet let it still be. So may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forevermore. Amen.